So in case you guys have been paying attention, I've mentioned LCAP a lot. And today, we're going to talk a little bit about that. LCAP, wow! In case you don't know, our first question we're going to answer is, what is LCAP? So LCAP is short for El Capitan. It is, quote, the monolith of Yosemite out in California. It's the tallest peak. It is 2,650 feet tall from the nose to where we rappel down to. In case you are a moviegoer or you've been paying attention, the most recent Oscar winner for Best Documentary was Free Solo. Free Solo is a movie about Alex Honnold climbing El Capitan without aid or assistance. So no rope, he was just him, his climbing shoes, and his chalk bag. That is not what I'm doing, just for the record, but that's the same, it's the same mountain, all right? So what am I doing there? So I am part of a rappel team and we are going to rappel the mountain. So essentially what that means is we're gonna hike the 10 to 12 miles up to the top of the mountain. We're gonna rig our static line and then we rappel off the nose down the mountain. So we use one solid rope, which means that we're dealing with things like the rope weight, because the rope weighs about as much as I do. And so you have to learn and be skilled enough to deal with the rope weight as you descend and be able to add and subtract bars, which is a thing on your rack. It's creating friction so that you don't, you know, just plummet. And so I'll be first hiking up on the rig hike, which means that we have to haul, in addition to our own gear, an additional 12 pounds of team gear up to the top. Also, thank you, Kevin Kissel, for making it only 12 pounds because I've been training for 20. After we finish rigging, the next day I'll be rappelling off of the nose. And at some point while we're there, I'll also be climbing that rope. So we rappel during the day and then our climbers will climb at night. And again, this isn't like rock climbing, it's called static rope ascension. So you saw some of this in our tag caving video. Here's like a kind of what this is gonna look like. We're essentially just going to be going vertically up the rope. We won't be touching the rock face at all unless our rope happens to be near it. So how did I get involved in this? So back in 2011, I decided to go to Wittenberg University, which is the only college who has a nationally recognized grotto of the National Speleological Society. It's a caving club. It's just like a higher level caving club. We had this because a great man named Dr. Horton Hobbs III worked at our university. He was a world-renowned biospeleologist. I owe a lot to that man, and I would not be the person I am if he had not decided to do that. So in 2011, I heard about the caving club. I didn't really start joining it until the following year. I went on my first trip, and then the year after that, my junior year of college, I was elected an officer of WUS. And now you might be saying, well, Tiffany, how does this relate to LCAP? It is the entire reason I get to go to LCAP. I learned single rope technique because that's how you enter and exit caves most of the time. So a lot of caves are vertical entrances, specifically some of the ones that, again, we did on our tag trip and that I've done on other tag trips. So after being a caver for a few years and becoming an adult, eventually I was invited to be on a Bridge Day team. So Bridge Day is the largest festival in West Virginia. It happens the third weekend in October. And if you come this year, you'll see me and a friend of mine rappelling the flags at the end of the day. The year I got on the Bridge Day team, we call them the big heads. They're the people who like decided to organize the trip for this year. They started talking about doing another LCAP trip. But essentially I got into it because I kept doing this stuff and I kept advancing and I wanted to, and eventually I got invited. Well, a question that a lot of people ask when they see me doing stuff like this is, oh, I would like to do that. Can I pay somebody to be able to do that? The answer is no, you can't. The only reason I'm able to do this is because I'm on a team and we got the permits to do this. We all had to have our own skill. This isn't like a touristy thing. None of us like paid money to be able to do this. So no, you cannot pay money to do this. It's not a tourist thing. This is like a, we all know each other and we've been training together to be able to do this. So just to make sure that's very clear, no, you cannot pay to do this. And then what types of training, I just mentioned that, did I have to do to be able to do this? A lot of the training I did on my own because I want to be able to like do these things pleasantly. I want to enjoy it. So I hiked 2 to 3 times a week carrying weight. I did a lot of hiking to train because that is the most difficult part for me as I'm a small female and I was gonna have to be carrying not only the weight of my gear, which weighs in at about 14 pounds, but additionally up to possibly 20 pounds of team gear, which is a pack weight of 34 pounds. Now people might say, oh, well people hike and they hike carry way more than that. You can carry up to 30% of your body weight and you'll be fine. Yeah, but I didn't really want to push what I was capable of doing. I didn't want to be incapable of pulling my own weight, if that makes sense. The other way we've been training for this, we did have 3 team trainings where we practiced things like passing the Jumar, rappelling with a pack with the rope weight, and other things like that, running the hall system, just so that everybody was really familiar with the system that we were going to be using to rig in and rappel. So that's some of the training I did. Other types of things out there that are similar to this, that are like big rappels that either I've done or I'm planning on doing in the future. So El Capitan is the like big one in the US. There's also Bridge Day, which is 876 from the catwalk. There's the Black Canyon in Colorado, which is about 2,000 feet as well. And then there's Golondrinas in Mexico, or the Cave of Swallows, if you want to use the English name. And that is about 1,700 feet, I think. And there are also like big caves in Vietnam and other countries, but this is kind of like the peak, the pinnacle of the rappel world in the United States. If you have any other questions that maybe I didn't answer, or that like something I said like is snowballing and now you wanna know, please let me know in the comments below. I'm in California right now, rappelling El Capitan, so I will get back to you next week. If you want to see more stuff like this or the rest of my El Cap series, there will be at least 2 more videos. We'll see how I decide. There might be 3 or 4. I don't know how much video I'm gonna take there yet. But let me know in the comments down below and hit that subscribe button so that you know when more El Cap videos are coming out. And we'll see you next week. Bye, guys.